Good morning, children. In last video, we have seen how much pressure difference will be acting between two points inside the static liquid. That is called gauge pressure. In a container, there was liquid which was static. We can take two positions, we can find out pressure difference between two positions. P2 minus P1 is equal to h rho g. H stands for height of liquid column, rho density of liquid, and g acceleration due to gravity. On the basis of this concept, we can say, we can think numerical problems. Suppose that problem there is a liquid, a static liquid in a container. This is the surface, lower surface. Here one body is kept. This is the height of liquid column. This height is 8 meter. This is the water. So we can find pressure at this position. We can find pressure equal h rho g, height of liquid column 8 meter, density of liquid, density of water, that is 10 to the power 3 kilogram per meter cube. You should know density of water 1000 kilogram per meter cube or 1 gram per centimeter cube. And g 9.8 meter per second square. Now we can write this one. Put it here 10 or 78.4 into 10 to the power 3 Pascal. This is the pressure you can find. It was question number 1. Now see question number 2. Suppose that there is a glass of shape this one. We have kept liquid in this container. Liquid in a container. We have to find pressure at this position and pressure at this position. It will be same or different, because this side shape is different and this side shape is different. We have to find pressure will be same or different given. So you have to state here give region, pressure is same or different. We'll say that pressure is same, region is that प्रेशर इज इक्वल टू एच रो जी, दिस टू टर्म्स आर कॉन्स्टेंट, पी इज इक्वल टू प्रोपोर्शनल टू एच, सो हियर हाइट इज सेम, हियर इज ऑल्सो हाइट इज सेम, बोथ हाइट आर सेम, सो प्रेशर एट ए एंड प्रेशर एट बी विल बी सेम एट दिस पोजिशन एंड एट दिस पोजिशन प्रेशर विल बी सेम, पी ए इक्वल टू पी. I think clear. So these are the applications of gauge pressure. Now, next topic. Pascal's law. Pascal's law. Statement pressure applied at one point of liquid container at one point of liquid will be transmitted to all other points of the container as well as wall of the container without changing its magnitude Suppose that there is a liquid container. Liquid is there. This is a volume. Here piston is connected. Here is also piston. Piston is connected here. Here is also piston. Area of the piston. Here is A1. Here is A2. Here is A3. We have applied force here. That is F1. Then obviously F2 force will act here according to Pascal. Here will be F3 force will act. Because this force is transmitted through the liquid to each portion of the container as well as molecules of liquid. So here, according to Pascal, if you take pressure at this position, F1 by A1 is equal to, we can find pressure at this position also, F2 by A2, this position also, F3 by A3. According to Pascal, all the pressure will be same. So, if you apply, I conclude this one, if you apply force, if you apply pressure at any position of the liquid part, this pressure will be transmitted throughout the liquid as well as the container of the water. So I think clear. This concept is utilized in hydraulic lift. So application. Hydraulic lift. This hydraulic lift is a machine by which we can lift any vehicle in a workshop for washing or for other purposes. It is looking like that. Here, water is kept here. Water or some special type of liquid is kept here, and it is the base. Here, vehicle is kept. When we apply small force at this position, its area of cross section is also small. When we apply force here, this force is small, this area of cross section is also small, then this force will be transmitted through the liquid and it will be applied here, that will be F. Its area of cross section is A. According to Pascal, we can state that pressure at this position and pressure at this position will be same. It means F by A is equal to F by A. If we want to find this force, then force is equal to F into A divided by A multiplied by this one, divided by this one. You can imagine, you can conclude here that this force will be large because this area of cross section is small and this area is large, that's why force will be large. So we have applied here very small force, but according to Pascal, very big force will be applied on that surface where vehicle is kept. So this is the best example of Pascal's, or we can say that this is the applications of Pascal's. Next topic. Atmospheric pressure. From name, it is clear. Pressure due to air column. Because in the atmosphere, air is present. Here is the Earth surface. If you want to find pressure at this position, then you have to take some air column, and due to this air column, pressure will be applied here, and that pressure is called atmospheric pressure. This pressure can be measured by barometer. This is called Torricelli's barometer. He has taken a container. In the container, he has taken mercury. He He also took a test tube that is kept inverted here. When it will kept inverted, then this mercury column will raise. Why raising? Because pressure is applied from this side. This side, that is atmospheric pressure, this side also atmospheric pressure. Due to this applied atmospheric pressure, mercury is raising up. When mercury is raised, but here there is no air, so it is called torricelli vacuum. Torricelli vacuum. And this height is calculated at a sea level, that is 76 centimeters. We can conclude here that pressure at these positions will be same, A, B, C, because levels are same. So pressure at A equal to pressure at B, C is equal to pressure at B. Pressure at A and C, that is the atmospheric pressure. So this will be atmospheric pressure equal to pressure at B, that is equal to H rho G. H, height of liquid column, that is equal to 76 centimeter. Density of liquid, this density, that is 13.6 into G, 9.8. When we will multiply this one, you will get here 1.015 into 10 to the power 5 Pascal. So it is called as 1 atmosphere. 1 atmosphere equal to 1.015, or 13, you can write it, 13 into 10 to the power 5 Pascal. So this is the method by which we can find atmospheric pressure. We can also find pressure of the gas using manometer. So what is manometer? This is manometer. Manometer, this is a container where gas is kept, and this type of tube is connected here. In this tube, mercury is taken, here is gas. Due to the pressure of the gas, mercury column depressed here and it is ready. Now we can say that pressure at A and pressure at B will be same, because level is same. So pressure at A is equal to pressure at B. Pressure at A, it is the pressure due to gas. So we can write here pressure due to gas. Pressure at B, this is the height H. So this will be equal to H rho G. Pressure due to this liquid column plus, here is also atmospheric pressure is acting, so pressure due to atmosphere also. I think it is clear that how you calculate the pressure of the gas. Pressure of the gas using the manometer will be equal to pressure due to this liquid column plus atmospheric pressure. In this way, I conclude that you can calculate in different ways how pressure will be calculated. Okay, thank you.